Governor Kemp today loosening some restrictions, like the number of customers allowed in restaurants and children in daycare classrooms.
He also extended the timeline that other businesses are going to be closed. Some businesses like bars, live music venues, nightclubs, they are going to remain shut, while summer day camps can open beginning this week. Overnight camps will not open. But following strict guidelines, public swimming pools will open. We have a complete breakdown of his executive order on 11alive.com. Hope Ford is at the state capitol with another big headline from today's briefing on the state's ability to treat some of its sickest patients, Hope.
Yeah, that's right. Georgia received 1,200 vials of the medicine Remdesivir. Now, Kemp says they're working with the Department of Public Health to figure out how that medicine is going to be distributed. Now, if you're wondering what Remdesivir is, it was initially created to treat patients with Ebola, but it wasn't very effective. Earlier studies have shown it can help with COVID-19, help those patients with COVID-19 recover faster. So the FDA granted emergency authorization use for the drug earlier this month. Now, some studies show side effects can include liver damage. So on that note, Dr. Kathleen Toomey says they won't distribute the drug without learning more about it.
We will, before we fully deploy, we will learn as much about it as we can. What it appeared to do is shorten the length of the illness in hospitalized patients, which is good news. But our own Emory University Hospital did some of those very trials, and we will be relying on their experience.
Now, the drug is not a cure, and it's still being studied for its effectiveness in COVID-19 patients, including at Emory University. And one study shows hospitalized patients who received the drug were discharged in 11 days versus 15 days with COVID-19 patients who received a placebo.